Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Trans-Siberian Orchestra!
Yeah.
city bar that is never too far from the places that gather, the dreams that have been in the safety of night with its old neon light. It beckons to strangers and they always come in. And the snow, it was falling. The neon was calling. The music was low. And the night, Christmas Eve. And here was the danger, that even with strangers inside of this night, it was easier to believe. For it was into this bar that I happened to wander, to stare into a glass and my universe ponder. So I walked up to the counter and shook the snow off my coat. Then I ordered a whiskey that I used like a moat. But an old man soon joined me and asked if I knew the time. One word led to another, and somehow I didn't mind. Then he offered me a drink from a bottle neath his coat, and smiled a little smile as it trickled down my throat. And I felt myself relaxing here among the ghosts that failed. Then the old man topped my glass off and began this little tale. In the moments of our lives, both the joyous and the tragic, if the truth is to be told, we are all pursuing magic. And the magic that we seek, as we're sure you have discovered, can be found in certain places far more easily than others. In the sand beneath the Sphinx, in the dreams of candlelight. But the surest place of all is in the forgiving world of night. And of all the nights throughout the year that come and gently leave, none hold the dream of magic like the evening, Christmas Eve. And so it's on this night, with its promise deep within, as the snow now starts to fall, our story does. Begin.
An angel came down one night to the earth, a mission from God to find out the worth of everything His children had done since that winter night, the birth of His Son. And then a sound filled the night in the cold winter air, and in the midst of His flight, it was holding Him there. And as He looked towards the earth, for the source of this sound on that cold winter night, it was pulling Him down. bring something back. The angel was told that no one could touch, but angels could hold. And so on that night, when the sky had cleared, among all the stars, an angel appeared. And then a sound filled the night in the cold winter air, and in the midst of his flight, it was holding him there. And as he moved towards the earth for the source of this sound, holding him there. And as he looked towards the earth for the source of this sound on that cold winter night, it was pulling him down.
The sound that he had heard was the ringing of the bells. But now inside that night, there were voices there as well.
In the middle of a forest, there's a clearing by a stream where from all the hosts a newborn and the child begins to dream, and he dreams of hopes unspoken when the tears of man will see. For he is the Prince of Peace. And the moon is looking downward, casting shadows through the trees. They whisper what they see, how the emperor and the pauper and the lion and the lamb kneel down before the newborn. For his peace, they understand. Born King, peace on earth and mercy in mind. God and sinners, they reconcile. Joyful, holy nations, arise, join the triumph. In Bethlehem, hark, the herald angels sing. Glory to the newborn King. His kingdom is at hand. So let the world rejoice together as we gaze upon that star, knowing every man is your brother, knowing every child is ours. Every
search, for he knew the answer to his quest was somewhere on this earth. And from London, Rome, and Paris, to Berlin, Tokyo, wherever the angel flew, that night, the skies would start to snow. As he flew over the Urals, he came upon a little town shining in the Arctic darkness. So the angel, he sat down. Then he walked among the people in a fitting earth disguise, so no one recognized him, though they wondered at his eyes. a village peasant. What do Russian hearts desire? The man answered, peace on earth, of course, and a little Stolichnaya.
Thank you.
flew o'er Sarajevo. There were scars upon the land. There were scars upon the people. It was hard to understand. And the deepest scars of all, which to humans are unseen, but the angel could see clearly, were the scars upon the dreams. Like Belfast and Burundi, Darfur, Palestine, the only decorations here have been awarded for their crimes. And in the gardens where the children played, now soldiers only trod. And stranger still, he heard some say that they were killing for their God. Now the angel had heard God speak many times, and he had always paid attention. But this killing of one's neighbor was something the Lord had never mentioned. But as he neared the earth of a recent battleground, from among the ruins, he once more heard the sound. It was a single cello playing a forgotten Christmas song. And even on that battlefield, the song somehow belonged. And as he flew away, the angel did take note that where he found this music played, one always could find hope. as he flew over the countryside, he was still listening when from a little church below, he heard a voice begin to sing.
Each that's a why. So they check the books full of prophecies, and the one king said, why, it's plain to me, you see, it means that a king is born who will save mankind on this blessed morn. Blessed morn. So they packed some gold, myrrh, and frankincense on some old camels and some Vincents. Closed down the house, sent the servants free, and the three kings arose in the history.
For the song, and he held it in his hand. It was something that he did because, you see, angels can. And he wondered to himself, is this the answer that I sought? But something still was missing, or at least so he still thought. And so he journeyed on through the midnight winter air, when all at once our angel was touched by a prayer. And once more looking to the earth to determine from whence it came, he felt a million souls below. But one was not the same. For there he saw a man alone, though he was walking in a crowd. And though this man had rarely prayed, tonight his head was bowed. For even in a crowd, you see, a heart can feel alone. When the night is Christmas Eve, and the child is not at home. So from the depths of this man's soul, a prayer did swiftly raise. And when the angel saw it first, He listened to its case.
There is an ornament lost inside the night. There on a Christmas tree with a thousand lights, no one can see her. She's standing all alone. Somewhere she glistens, no one can see.
After he had heard the prayer, the angel gently set it free and followed it to the father's child in a faraway city. And there the girl, in desperation, was searching through the sky for a star that she could wish upon. But stars were in short supply. The only light that she could see, there, shining all alone, was a neon sign on an old city bar. And so on this, she wished she was home. Now every light can be a star, just depends on where you are and the distance that you're looking past the places you have been and the dreams you left behind and the dreams you left within.
Places that gather the dreams that have been in the safety of night, with its old neon light, it beckons to strangers, and they always come in. And the snow, it was falling, the neon was calling. The music was low, and the night, Christmas Eve, and here was the danger. Even with strangers inside of this night, it's easier to be. Someone was lost, standing outside our door. Then the bartender gazed through the smoke and the haze, through the window and dice, to that corner street light. We're standing alone by a broken payphone. Was a girl, the child said, could no longer get home. And the snow, it was falling, the neon was calling. The bartender turned and said, not that I care, but how would you know this? The child said, I've noticed, if one could be home, they'd be already there. And the bartender came out from behind the bar, and in all of his life he was never that far. And he did something else that he thought no one saw. When he took all the cash from the register drawer, then he followed the child to the girl across the street. And we watched from the bar as they started to speak. Then he called for a cab, then he said, JFK, put the girl in the cab, then the cab drove away. And we saw in his hands that the cash was all gone, from the light that she had wished upon.
If you want to arrange it, this world you can change it. If we could somehow make this Christmas thing last by helping a neighbor or even a stranger to know who needs help. You need only just wasn't there, just the wind and the snow waltzing dreams through the air. So he walked back inside, somehow different, I think. For the rest of the night, no one paid for a drink. And the cynics will say, that's a neighborhood kid. Wandered in on some bums in the world where they hid. But they weren't there, so they couldn't see. By an old neon star on that night, Christmas Eve. Snow, it was falling, the neon was calling, in case you should wonder, in case you should care, why we on our own never went home on that night of all nights.
Then, all at once, inside that night, he saw it all so clear. The answer that he'd sought so long had always been so near. It's every gift that someone gives, expecting nothing back. It's every kindness that we do, each simple little act.
Christmas time on a cold December morning. All is calm and the world is still asleep. Christmas lights that have been caught without warning.
And it's good that we remember, just as soon as we've discovered that the things we do in life will always end up touching others. So, from a fading neon star, somewhere shining in the night, we find a father far away, now reflecting in its light.
Thank you. Merry Christmas, Merry, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas, have a Merry Christmas.
Oh,
And so, with his story over and our bottle nearly through, I asked, did this really happen? He swore every word was true. Then he said, I see you're puzzled, for your mind tells you to doubt me, that my story can't be true, but your heart tells you it might be. He then asked, did it entertain me? And I admitted, it had charm. Then he said, perhaps you have learned something, or at worst, I've done no harm. Then he rose up from his chair and said it's time that he should leave. But may God keep you and protect you this and every Christmas Eve. Then he left through the front door, and I ran out to ask him back. But he was already gone, and stranger still, he left no tracks. So I walked back to my home, recalling all I'd heard and seen. And that night, for the first time since my childhood, I dreamed a Christmas dream. Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas!
Great to be back here, and I want to say one more time, for the few of you that weren't in your seats yet, we got out a half hour late today. That is because one of our tour buses broke down with our crew members in it, so we took a little bit longer to get started, but these guys finished the show actually a couple hours faster than they should have. And this is one group of people you have to thank, because we have the two shows today, the two tomorrow, the next 4 days after that are two. We couldn't do it without our crew. Give them a huge round of applause! Includes Mr. Dave Whittenbeck, our sound engineer. He's done every record we've ever done, every tour we've ever been on. Everybody say, hi, Dave!
Hi, Dave!
It also includes Mr. Brian Hartley back there. He designs these light shows you guys love so much. Everybody say, thank you, Brian!
Thank you, Brian!
Awesome. Thinking of thanking somebody, it's you guys. This is our 21st year on the road. We would not have made it past, yep, we wouldn't have made it past 21 days without you guys. So we thank you for these first magical 21 years on the road. Another group of people we thank every day of our lives with TSO is each and every member, past, present, and future, of our United States military. They protect our lives and our freedom. We thank them every single day with TSO. Are you ready to meet the singers in the band? Our lovely ladies here. Would you please welcome back Miss Natalia Rose? From London, England, Miss Georgia Napolitano. It's her very first tour with TSO, Miss Haley Dorley. Our Princess of Peace, Miss Erica Jerry. This next young lady comes from Dallas, Texas, gonna do a really special song second half of our show. Welcome back, Miss Kayla Reeves. Moving on to the guys. Beginning with Mr. Zachary Stevens. On vocals and guitars, DDB Diamond, Dustin Braley. From the Netherlands, Mr. Robin Morgan. And once again, welcome back from Asheville, North Carolina, Mr. Caleb Johnson. All right, now every single the show we do at TSO, one of Paul O'Neill's beautiful stories is brought to life through the magical voice of the next gentleman we're going to introduce to y'all. Would you please say hello to our storyteller, the incredible Mr. Brian Hicks! Once again, the TSO vocalist and Mr. Brian Hicks, give it up extra loud! Some of your TSO favorites. We're going to do some stuff we've never done live before, including one song that we never even released as a TSO song before. But right now, why don't we take you to the calm before the storm?
night is growing dark. Somewhere deep within, it shelters like an arm. It always takes you in, and the mind goes numb when it's feeling no pain. The soul cries out for a handful of rain.
Yeah. Oh,
we're going to introduce you all to the musicians that you see on stage. Are you ready to meet the band? Alright, something you may or may not know, every single city that you travel to with the Trans-Siberian Orchestra, we get the opportunity to work with seven the most amazing local musicians in our string section. So these string players are from your own cities and towns. Give them a huge round of applause! Conducting our strings today, tonight and every show on the story, it's Rowdy Roddy Chung! On the bass guitar, give it up for Tony Dickinson! My partner in crime on the electric guitar, give it up for Joel Hoekstra! The man on the drums, 21 years ago, our very first tour, very first show on the drums, every single one since, from Horseheads, New York, Mr. Jeff Blake! On keyboards, 20 years ago, first time he came to New England with TSO. On keyboards then, member of family ever since, please welcome back Miss Me and Kim! And last but not least, this gentleman to my right, he's our musical director. Also on keyboards, please say hello to Mr. Derek Wieland. My name is Chris Caffrey, and we are the Trans-Siberian Orchestra. And there would be no Trans-Siberian Orchestra without this next member of the band we're going to introduce to y'all. He's our special angel in heaven, the creator of TSO, our lyricist, composer, and producer, Mr. Paul O'Neill. Paul would always say to us, and sometimes we didn't really pay attention to it, but it was something that was so obvious, but sometimes you lose track. And he said that time was our most precious and valuable commodity. And like I said, sometimes we lose track of that. And this summer, we were in the studio listening to some old recordings, and we came upon a 35-year-old cassette tape recording of Paul and a song he wrote. It was just him singing and playing an acoustic guitar, Paul being Paul. And at that time, we realized just how correct he was about that statement he made about time. And we're gonna play that song for you now, the very first time ever. It's a song called Hey, Can You Hear Me Now? It's gonna be sung by Miss Kayla Rees and Boss, We Hear You Loud and Clear.
Can you hear? the low on your own retreating. Regretful for the things you're not and all the dreams you haven't got. Without a home, a heart of stone lies bleeding. And for all the roads you follow, and for all you did not find, and for all the dreams you had to leave behind, I am the way, I am the light, I am the dark inside the night. I hear your hopes, I feel your dreams, and in the dark I hear your screams. Don't turn away, just take my hand. When you make your final step, I'll be right there. I'll never leave, and all I ask of you is believe. Grown-up wings you needed. So when you had to add them on, you found that they were not enough to get you in and pay for sins repeated. And for all the years you borrowed, and for all tears you hide, and for all the fear you had to keep inside. I am the way, I am the light, I am the dark inside the night. I hear your hopes, I feel your dreams, and in the dark I hear your screams. Don't turn away, just take my hand. When you make your final step, I'll be right there. I'll never leave. No.
Thank you.
for putting up with a little bit of delay before the start of the show. It was worth it because you guys were absolutely wonderful. We'll see you next time with the Trans-Siberian Orchestra. Peace and good night!
Ça va être jamais bien.